This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. In this tutorial, I'm going to try and simplify the process and take you through, or walk you through, the process of packaging a simple Python project. Now, we have already created our project in the previous section. That is the SQL Query Inspector Middleware, the Django tool that we created in the previous tutorial. This is where we left the code in the previous section of the course. We have created our middleware. Remember, this is SQL Query Inspector, so we're going to output queries that have been generated from a Django view in the terminal. And then we can inspect some of the different details about those queries. Now, although we are just simply taking this middleware and making it into a package which we can distribute via the Python package index, it's worth mentioning that we may do this to a whole Django application. Imagine we build a module of some sort within our application that we want to utilize in other applications, in other Django applications. So we can go ahead and package up the whole Django app here. But of course, here we just simply have some middleware that we need to package. So let's just go ahead and create a new folder here. And we'll call this, for example, SQL package. So we'll just call this SQL package for now, new folder. So let's go ahead and make a copy of our package, place it. I'm just going to copy that into our new package folder here. So that's the second thing we're going to need. Now, we're going to put the package inside of a folder. That's going to be the name of our package, if you like. So we're going to call this Very Academy SQL Tools. Okay, so that's the folder. And then we're going to go ahead and put our package code inside of this folder. So this is going to be our actual, this folder here inside the SQL package project. This is going to be our main source for our actual package that we want to distribute. In this case, we'd simply just have one file, and that's the middleware. So you do want to make sure that this name here, it's not very friendly, but we want to make sure that our folder name here, Very Academy SQL Tools, that it's unique. This is going to be our project name, and we can utilize this as the actual project name that's going to be utilized on the Python package index. But we need to make sure that that is unique. So at this point, we simply just concentrate now on adding the files that we're going to need so that we can prepare our package here. So that it can be prepared and stored and distributed on the Python package index. I will later on in this course introduce build tools, which can be utilized to actually automate this type of process of building the structure, the files that are needed in order to package and create a distribution. In this course, we are going to manually create all the files or the basics of our package, so that we can prepare our project for distribution. So the first thing that we're probably going to need here, so we're working inside of our SQL package folder here. Now remember that the middleware is inside of our package here, Very Academy SQL Tools. So first thing we're going to need then is create a new file, and we're probably going to need some sort of license file. So here we're just going to specify the license. So we just create a new file, license, and then we can go ahead and add our license in there. So again, with the build tools that we can utilize, that would automatically generate this for us. So I'm just going to copy and paste a MIT license in there. In addition to that, we may also include some sort of README file. So README dot, that can be a markdown or other types. So let's just call that README.md. So that's our README file. As you might appreciate, Django or Python developers have been creating Python packages for many years. And over that time, the approaches have changed. Now, that doesn't mean that older approaches of building packages will still not work or be just as effective. It just means that there have been new tools created and new approaches which can streamline this process. I mention this because if you have read any additional materials, or if you are going to read any additional materials, you may find that the approaches displayed or presented will be slightly different. What we need to do now is supply some metadata to provide the configuration options and data that is needed to display our package on the Python package index, or the information that's needed, as well as identifying other important aspects such as how to build and customize the build of the package. So what I mean by the build of the package is that we're going to supply a code, supply some instructions here, so that when we actually build our application, it's going to then be converted into a format which we can then upload, and the Python package index can then read and then use to actually display our package correctly on the Python package index. Nowadays, we can supply everything we need in one file. So within our main directory here, let's create a new file. Let's call this classically PyProject. Okay, so here we have a new file, which we're now going to supply the additional metadata information about our application so that we can successfully build our package and also supply all the additional information which the Python package index may need to actually display and host our package. So you may have noticed that we utilize this TOML format here. If you're not familiar with TOML, it is a way of creating a minimal configuration file, or is considered a minimal configuration file format. Ultimately, it's a text file with some useful semantics that provides a way of easily working with the data within the file. So there is a whole bunch of stuff that we can include here. And I'm just going to take you through the basic setup here so that we can just get this distributed. And then you can go ahead and read and explore some of the documentation and add and maybe include more additional data as you wish. So first of all, we're going to define some of the project metadata. So the first being the name. So this is going to be the name of our package. Now that's going to match this folder name here. So this name here is going to match our folder name we created earlier, where we actually included the code for our package, which is the middleware file. So that's the name. Right, so next up is a version. So we want to maintain a record of the different versions of this application or this package. So we need to specify a version and then also a description of some sort. So I've just added a basic description here, a Django middleware package to print out queries to the terminal. So we did previously add a README file. So I'm just going to link to that. So README equals README.md, markdown file there. And then in addition to that, we did also add a license file. I'm just going to link to that license file. If we go back to the Python package index, you can start to see what some of this is going to be, some of this data is going to be presented. Here we have the project description. Looks like we've got some additional links down here, one of them being, for example, the license. And we also have an author, which we haven't described yet, a requirements, which we'll detail in a minute. So we can start to see some of the different links, as well as maybe a homepage of some sort. So let's have a look at some of the other options. So we saw there on the Python package index, we could specify, for example, some different requirements, one of them being what version of Python your package supports. So let's just add as a recording the latest Python version. Now, of course, it will probably work on earlier versions of Python. We're just going to add that in there now, and you can go ahead and change that as you like. So here I'm just specifying that this package will work on Python that's version 3.11 and upwards. So write chevron equals 3.11. So 3.11, Python 3.11 and upwards, this package would be working for, or we can say that we're going to support this package on Python version 3.11 and upwards. Now, the reality is that this will probably work on version 3 upwards, so you could change that if you like. Now, let me just quickly provide you some information regarding the core metadata specifications. So if we go head over to, or we just type in core meta specifications into Google, for example, that should take you to the page, this page here, hosted the, this is the, from the Python documentation, this is the package user guide. So you can see here in the core metadata specifications, this is some of the different options that we have available. Now, we've already mentioned some of these here, for example, the name and the version, as well as the description. So if you want to list and read through some of the different options that are available, by default, at least you can have a look through this documentation here. So let's go ahead and add some project URLs. So I'm going to specify, for example, a home page, but you can go ahead and add some additional links if you like. So this is just going to link to the Very Academy GitHub page. So not a link directly to the project just yet, but let's just add something there for now. So now we have this core set of information here. Let's also think about our package. Now, let's remember that in order for this middleware to work successfully, you notice that in addition to Django, which needs to be installed, we'll make the assumption that someone who's actually going to use this package will have Django installed. So one thing that we're also going to need to provide if they were to install this package is that we're going to need to install the other dependencies in order to actually get this code working correctly. Now, remember here, we're using PyGemint and SQL parse. So those are some additional dependencies or packages that will need to be installed whenever anyone were to download and install our package from the Python package index. So we're going to need to specify that within our project, and we can do that by specifying that within dependencies. So let's add that right there. So we have some dependencies here. So we're going to describe, or we're going to define the fact that whenever someone installs this via pip, for example, on their machine, it will also install PyGemint above or equal to version 2.14.0 and SQL parse, so above or equal to version 0.43. So hopefully you can start to see how that's being generated. Very simple. Have a look at the documentation, as I mentioned, and have a look through if you want to add some additional information. So something actually I've forgotten here is the authors. I'll just drop that in just down here. So authors equals Very Academy. License, readme, description, version, name. Okay. So that's pretty much all the core metadata specifications that we're going to define in this project. Now, there is something missing here, and we will discuss that in the next tutorial. That is going to be our build system. So before we leave, let's just add an initialization file here in our project. There we go. And then you can now see the project to date. So we have the main folder here, SQL package, and then we have our actual package folder here, which we've named veryacademy-sql-tools. Inside of here, we have our actual package code. So we now have the nucleus of our package here. We have the package folder here where we're storing our actual package and our code. So notice that we created a new folder for that. We have a license file, a readme file, and also then our configuration specifications. Like I alluded to, you may see other approaches where there is an additional file here. I'm going to include everything, and some might consider this a more modern approach to packaging, but everything is going to be stored here and defined in the project.toml file.